For 30 years or 40 years in Oxford University, they've delved deeply into the philosophical ideas.
It's not only that God is one.
Of language. And these guys actually think that they know the truth.
Are you done?
I mean, seriously.
No, he's not done. He'll get.
Do you actually believe you know the truth?
No, but I'm going to have a go at it, all right?
That is a good answer.
God is not only one. Hashem Elok, Yehovah Elokeinu Hashem Echad, means not only that God is one, means that there is only one, right? And there isn't multiple, but He is the only thing that exists, right? Which means there's, just a minute, which means there's nothing else in this world, there's nothing else in the entire creation, there's nothing else in the entire creation apart from Him.
And answer this.
So everything that you see, just a minute, everything that you see, everything that exists, whether it is physical or non-physical, whether it's something that is alive and breathing, whether it's something that's growing, or whether it's a stone, everything is only exists with the energy of God, right? And that's something that has been scientifically proven most recently with the science of atoms, where you see that in everything, even a dead piece of stone, if you look deep inside it, there's an energy that keeps it going. So there's the energy of God in everything, which means that God is not only one, but He is the only thing. So if you ask me who is God and where is God, God is everywhere. Why? Because everything only exists because of God's presence and energy. And everything that we see is a materialistic...
Answer this. Why is His name... Okay. Bereshit bara Elohim. Et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz.
Yes.
Okay? Yeah. So Elohim is a plural because it says im at the end. He is the oneness. Yes. We have white light. White light. It's one white light, yeah?
I don't know what white light
red,
is.
Red, yellow, blue. This guy knows you have light. You have the one God.
Don't tell me you're going to make Trinity out of that.
I'm not. No, Trinity's not in the Bible, but God it is. Trinity is Catholic. We're talking about the one God, Elohim. Why is He called Elohim? The oneness. Why does He say, who? You know, Isaiah chapter 6, Yeshayahu. Yeshayahu, Kachstam, Shalash, Shalba, Hamesh, Shesh. Yeah? He says, who will go for us?
Yes.
Who will go for us? So He is one, and yet His name is Elohim.
Elohim is Inzigo.
Yes. Okay, well, okay. Elohim means our God. Elohim is our God.
No, no, right? He makes it plural.
No,
it's ours. You don't know Diktok. So you don't know.
No, that's not true.
It is.
It is true. It you is. Don't know how. Have you learned biblical Hebrew?
Elohim does not mean our God.
It is.
I've got a B in classical Hebrew A level.
In modern Hebrew,
and Elohim does not in modern Hebrew. In classical Hebrew, biblical Hebrew, right?
Maybe your rabbi
and
has
I can tell you.
No, they don't
gamble on
and
the
rabbi.
And it doesn't make any sense anyway. It's all written in a book, which isn't that good. Why are you bothered what's written in a book like that?
We agree
what that we need to speak about is the atrocities that are if God is everywhere, God is in COVID.
Yes, God
is
cannot
war,
become his creation.
God is
but,
in rape.
But,
God is in murder.
I'm going to tell you about,
God is in child abuse.
Because God
that's
is what he
like
is, and he's so vast,
and you Jews, and you
can't even comprehend.
And you believe
God
in
had
God,
to limit
say God is
and diminish his energy, which means is that God is not a tree, right? God is not a person. God is not a stone. But God wanted
and
to
create.
No, God is not a stone. And God is not.
That?
But God wanted to create that. So in order to create that, God had to diminish certain aspects of himself in order that this...
So who was so Abraham a friend of?
Just a minute.
He's a person of God.
No, he's not a person.
Abraham was called a friend of God.
Yes. Yes. Can we deal
but
with
he's not,
suffering?
That doesn't mean that God is
you
a person.
You can know God.
Forget
God
the book.
You can know him.
Let's
he speaks to you, but that doesn't make him a person.
God has a heart.
Yeah. David
has a heart.
Was a man after God's own. He has a spirit.
It's a heart.
So Maimonides says on that, that those are all...
Who says what?
Maimonides.
Yeah, well, who cares? What does the Bible
say? I'm telling you how to interpret it. You want to interpret it, so I'll tell you, someone that was 1,000 years before you and a bit smarter than all of us, I'll tell you his interpretation, so that might make more sense.
So he was smarter than me, was he?
I suggest so. If you look on his works... Can
was
I see?
Smarter than David?
Do you have
Malik
works
David
that compare anything near to Maimonides?
I found in David a man after my own heart. You don't. I'm in English, did you? You got to be pretty thick to realize that God is a personal God who has a heart because he. David was a man after God's own heart.
We should understand it.
What do you mean literal?
That we should understand it.
A four-year-old would understand
that. Because when I talk to... No,
God
because
has
in
a
human
heart.
Language, when you talk about love,
you want to
it's
complicate everything.
No.
Typical Jew
want
to complicate everything.
That we can't comprehend.
Then you make money out of it by charging to be lawyers.
So Abraham couldn't comprehend God.
Yes?
God spoke. We're not shouting. We're debating in a strong, nice way.
Joshua, I just want to make something very simple. Please, why are we shouting over each other?
We're not shouting.
Do we all believe that God is one and unique? Joshua.
Yes.
Thank you.
We believe one thing. La ilaha illa Allah.
Does he believe that? Let's go there. Do you believe that?
What?
Let's have some common ground.
Can you answer the question about suffering? Why does your God allow such terrible suffering in the world? Why did your God allow the Holocaust to happen? Why did your God allow people in the hospital right now with cancer, children? Why does your God allow war in Yemen? Why does your God allow racism? Why does your God allow drug addiction?
Who is your God?
What's that?
Who is your God?
Who's my God? Well, I don't have a God. I'm trying to understand how can you explain, it doesn't matter about what my God is. Answer the question.
You don't have a God.
Answer the question. It's irrelevant about whether I have a God or not. Answer the question. Why does your God allow so much terrible suffering in the world? And animals suffer as well. Why?
If
he's so loving.
If you don't have a God, we can't have a conversation on this. Right?
What?
If you would have a different God, you would be able to discuss why my God allows things that your God doesn't or does allow. If you don't have a God,
okay, I have a God. I don't have a God. My God is the everlasting void.
The void.
Which nothingness.
Okay.
Nothing.
So nothingness creates
the void. The void. Yeah.
How does that work?
Can God stay in heaven?
I think that you'll.
And that makes more sense to you than there is a God.
No. Nothingness. Just nothingness.
So nothingness creates.
If you have to comprehend. Listen, I don't understand.
God that has a bigger
what has it got to do? What has it got to do with what I believe about God? I'm asking you a question. You believe in this all wonderful, powerful God, and you.
Yes.
I was brought up in the same religion you were, and I used to spend my hours and hours saying, how great you are, God. Until one day I thought to myself, hold on a minute, you're not actually that great after all, are you?
His body died, but his spirit goes straight to be with the Father in heaven.
The Messiah gave his life. The son of David, the son of Daoud, Psalm 110, the Lord said unto my Lord, he's the one, he's the Messiah who came and he gave his body as a sacrifice. Just as in the temple, you've got to believe in the temple. Come on. And the tabernacle. You believe in the temple, he believes in the temple. Because that was a reflection, that did not get rid of sin. It was a covering for sin. But to actually take away sin, there has to be full punishment. Now he fully got. He took the punishment for us out of love. That's what he did.
Did God die in the flesh, or he didn't die?
He died spiritually. No, I just said physically. He took his last breath. Why? Because he was fulfilling Psalm 22. David. He quoted Psalm 22 when he was actually on the cross.
David,
and by the way, Yeshua. Okay. Yeshua didn't have long blonde hair. He didn't have white skin. He was a dark skinned Israeli carpenter, and his name was Yeshua. He was not Catholic.
You're very passionate.
What a lot of Orthodox believe Jesus is Catholic.
Joshua.
I've met Catholics who believe he's Catholic.
Joshua. Let's stick to topic because we're going off topic.
I'm not joking.
So far, we've agreed that God is unique. There's nothing like Him. Yes. Okay. He does not. From what we can agree,
we agree that
there is nothing like Him. So the concept of God coming down to earth to us is blasphemous, and it's also an impossibility.
Yeah.
Because we say,
me too. He stayed in heaven.
As Muslims, we say
the
God.
The Messiah. Okay.
So I'm speaking. You're reading passion. I admire passion, by the way. Yeah. What I'm saying is the following. we say God does what befits His Majesty. So I can't come and say if I go to Mike Tyson and I say to Mike Tyson, listen, if you're really a strong guy, let me knock you out and don't touch me. Does that show his power or his weakness?
We're not here for that.
Don't touch me.
If I say to Mike Tyson, show me how powerful you are. I'm going to punch you in the mouth and don't hit me back. Would this show his power or his weakness?
If he didn't hit you back.
Yes.
I think he would hit you back, but if he didn't, I think it was his self-resolve and self-control.
There's a difference in physical power and mental power.
What's that got to do with God being in
heaven? The analogy I'm trying to give is the following, because a lot of people say God can do whatever He likes. So, and they say, oh, He's the most powerful. But I believe for God to come down on earth and, God forbid, be a tree, we believe that doesn't befit His Majesty and it doesn't show His power. Because it's like me going to my Tyson and saying, you better show me how powerful you are. I'm going to punch you in the mouth and I'm going to spit on you and you don't touch me. He will show His weakness.
God was in heaven. God never left heaven. It's quite simple.
No.
God never left heaven.
What I'm trying to say is that...
He's always been in heaven in perfection. You're not getting my point. You're implying that He left heaven.
What I'm trying to say is the following. In a physical...
Is it a question or are you preaching? We need to have a debate, not a preach.
If you allow me to speak there.
What's your question? We need to ask questions.
I'm trying to come to you. In the physical aspect, yes, it shows His strength that He's holding. He can kill me if He wants, yeah? But I'm saying in the physical aspect, it shows His weakness, because if I go and say, oh, if you're really strong, kiss my feet, it doesn't show His power. So just as God Almighty is the most powerful, to say He can do whatever He likes, He can become a man if He likes, is not in His Majesty. It doesn't show His power, it shows Him being weak. So we're saying that, do you believe God can come down to earth as a human being and die on the cross?
Okay, I've got a question. Like okay, you've had your preach.
Now, I believe He wouldn't do it, and He didn't do it.
Now,
and He won't.
How is the Messiah, as it says in the prophecy?
We're talking about God.
How can God send the Messiah? Who do you think this Messiah is? You believe he's the son of Dawood? He's the son of Ben
David. That's not a topic, though.
Yes, he has to be.
We're talking about God and His attributes.
Yeah, we're talking about God sending the Messiah who came down to earth, who claimed to be the son of David. Stick to the point. I am. I'm sticking to the point. So who do you think the Messiah? My Messiah.
No, but that's off topic. We're not talking about that.
What about you? I'm asking you, who is this God who's sending His Messiah? Who is this Messiah going to be? Who's he? Is he going to be the son of David?
He's going to be a direct male descendant of David, yes.
Of the tribe of Judah.
Stop it. We're not talking about God coming down to earth, and God sent His Messiah. No, we never denied that. Of course, we believe that Muslims, we believe Jesus was the Messiah. That's a topic that we disagree, and we're more on your side.
The Jewish Messiah, yeah? You believe he's a Jewish Messiah?
He was a Jewish, of course he was Jewish, he was a Messiah. We believe that, we're more on your side on this, but I'm saying we're talking about the attributes of God. Can you fathom that the one who created the heavens and the earth and everything around us came to earth as a man? Does that befit His Majesty? That's the question I'm asking.
Does it befit God's Majesty to stay in heaven in all His...
Okay, now, hear me out. I'm trying to be fair here. Let me hear him out, then I'm going to come to you.
Sorry,
you don't believe it befits His Majesty.
Of course.
I'm on you on this page. Why do you believe God Almighty in His Spirit can send down a Messiah and then spiritually, in His Spirit, be in His body to die for the sins of the world? How is that possible?
Because He's God. He did not leave the majesty on high. He did not leave the majesty. The Almighty God, Elohim Adonai Yehovah, He stayed in heaven 100%. But He sent the Messiah, who was the Son of Man, as in Daniel, the Son of Man, the Son of David, and the Son, which you don't believe and you don't believe, which is the contentious thing, the Son of God. Now, you don't believe that. But I believe God can do that. What was His first name? He's called 700 times in this book. He's called Adonai Yeshua Mashiach. You don't believe He's Lord. You don't believe He's Lord. You believe what you believe is a charlatan.
Lord,
but you believe
God,
He's
God.
The Jewish Messiah. I believe He's a Jewish Messiah. 700 times, do you think God, Almighty God, is going to make 700 mistakes about the name of the Messiah?
That's
a big mistake.
David, we need to even
but according to the Injil, God made 700 mistakes.
David, what we're saying is...
That don't fit, man.
David, what we're saying is we would even argue if it's even the word of God. That's another topic.
Yeah, I know.
That's a different topic.
You don't believe that. You believe in the Injil.
Can you explain
with
to me...
With all the things from here that fit in with your...
David, please. Can you explain to me how does God Almighty... Can you tell me why would God find the need to come down as a human being? Is that possible? That's what I want to know.
Yeah, why wouldn't he? If he's going to really deal with sin, okay. Not just cover okay. sin as
can,
in the tabernacle.
Can God become a tree?
And stay in heaven.
But can he become a tree?
Could God become a tree? He could, but he wouldn't because that's stupid. That's stupid.
Brilliant.
So he's not going to do something stupid.
Brilliant. Thank you, Dave. Now, what did he say? Listen carefully, Joshua. He can, but he
Let's
wouldn't.
Let him speak a little bit more because I've done too much.
Joshua, am I speaking over you? Sorry.
So your view is that Yeshua did not send his, the question. Stick to the question.
My view is the Messiah has not yet come. My view is that Jesus was indeed a charlatan.
And you believe that the Messiah will come and he will be the great ruler. Yeah, and he will redeem the world.
No, but this is off topic, David. You keep getting off topic.
Wait, it's your topic.
I'm talking about God. You're talking about Messiah.
This is not a Dawah program. This is a three-way conversation. You do not dictate what's going to be.
No problem.
We are having a three-way conversation.
Okay, I'm going. Guys, we had a nice discussion there. We tried to have a discussion. We have
you tried to dominate the discussion. We can talk about what we want to talk about.
I'm going.
I think the problem here is that you're not actually arguing. You're just asking questions and then asking them again and again to him to try to get him to change his answer so that he'll agree with you, but you know he doesn't.
Yes, so all we've come to establish is that your concept of God, because it seems that we totally disagree, yeah? So we believe in the same concept of God. There's one question that I want to ask you as a Jewish man, yeah?
Yes.
Do you believe God, that God rested on the seventh day, the sixth day?
In a manner of saying yes, but what we consider rest is not the same thing as the divine.
Yes.
Okay, so you don't believe he was tired?
Obviously not.
Okay, thank you. That's good, because what we believe in Islam is that God doesn't get tired, and he, what he does is because his majesty. So we don't believe, because I had the concept, which I wanted to clarify, that I thought Jews believe that God actually got tired, and so
no,
you don't believe in that.
Same with me.
Okay, that's good.
In the Hebrew, it's
so God does not get tired, yeah? That's good. Okay, thank you. That's what I wanted to know. Thank you. I'm so sorry for disturbing you guys. Joshua, it was a pleasure. Virus, yes. Yes. David? Okay. Enjoy
Salam.
Your conversation.
Salam.
Take it. Shalom. Take it.
Oh, I love you.
So.